have here, made by Heckler & Koch, the 40A1, 40mm round, but they made this specifically, so in the future we can get larger projectiles. It's going to be 40mm, the average is 2.46. So, there's not any disassembly to this, besides taking this buttstock off and putting it on your M4 or your M16.
Oh shit.
Yeah, it's really basic. It's just a basic bench, just in here. Pretty much slide it on. Yeah.
Slide it on.
It'll lock itself in there. So you just use this as a forward grip. But the thing is, you're going to have to shoot this left hand now versus using it all by itself with its own buttstock.
As opposed to me being left handed, I'd have to shoot it right handed.
Yeah, you would, if you're in.
You just switch right. Whatever you want.
It's as easy as that, having out to your 4 and 16. What's really cool though is, in your case, it's ambidextrous, so the safety is on both sides. And also, you can take these sides out and put them onto the other side. But I like to keep them on the right side because if I'm using it by itself, I can still put this right in my shoulder. If it was on the right side, I'll put it in my chest just because I'm using the right eye. It goes from an increment to 50, from 50 to 350, but you can, of course, you can see a lot further than that. The area point target is 150, so you'll do pretty accurate at that. The area target, you can kind of get in the vicinity, is 300. So. It's kind of self-explanatory. You just put the white dot right in the middle where it goes, line the flaps up with the flaps. So he's gonna have to tilt it up and open up. It looks, you can kind of really see how, so this is 50, right? And this is 350. So it changes the weapon. It's not loud. It shoots it, you can watch the whole time. You don't even need the sights if you got plenty of rounds. Shoot one, okay, you see where it went. Try not to move. So, shoot one, you see where it went, okay, moving in. Adjust, I'm going to be moving to it again. Okay, I was pretty close. I wouldn't suggest if you shoot it and it does not fire.
So keep.
Yeah, try to pull the trigger again. Okay, it's not doing it. Pull it down range and let somebody know. Don't try to open it and like, okay, well, yeah. Just leave it in there. Pointing down range, because just in case, you know, it goes off a couple of seconds later, you're not pointing at the tower like, hey, it's not working. Another cool thing is, it comes with its own toy, or tool, I mean, it's a toy of itself, but it comes with its own tool. And it's just an Allen wrench. So, you're going to use this to either take off your hand grip or your sights. If you are extending your sights, you need to take the top piece off because the way this works is you just take it like that. So you need to take the top off and rotate it around. So that's the only thing you can really use this for. There's nothing that you need to take apart. So, for cleaning, you just open this up, clean this shit out, whatever you're putting in there, make sure it's appropriate, because it does look...
Make sure it's appropriate.
And you need to make sure it's back here. Like, the firing pin comes out, and while you're cleaning it, feel for the firing pin. If you don't feel it, that's good. What you can do to make sure that the firing pin is working properly, like, not shooting it, if it wasn't shooting, put your finger on the little hole and pull the trigger. This is one of my favorite toys the Army has. Take it out and be careful with my baby. a lot of fun. Whenever you're qualifying, there's only going to be 9 targets to pop up. The times from 50 to 400. I think you get 9 reps. It goes, you don't have to hit the target, it just goes by how close.
Darn key.
No.
The Army Reserves. Oh, is that a wrap?
That's a wrap.
All right, that's a wrap.
Right, like, nice. Very well.